Hello friends, in this video we will see some MapReduce flow. These are the topics I am going to cover. If you would like to know more about Big Data, HDFS and how HDFS and MapReduce solving the problem of Big Data and how YARN came into the picture, please watch our other videos from TechCore Easy channel. Let's see what is a map, what is a reduce. So map, as name itself indicate, it is a mapping some another value, and reduce, reducing it. To see some example, if you know SQL, while selecting the columns, you are calculating a age from a given date of birth column. So that is a mapping. You are mapping some new value to one value. So you are generating some new value, and reduce, it reduces the value. So here example is like a aggregation function. So if you have 100 records and you aggregate it, some depends on some value, sample city, and you find out how many employees are present per city. So at that time the records are reduced. So in the Hadoop, in the big data world, the map reduce phase always accepts the input in the key value pair format and returns the output in the key value pair format. So let's recap what is HDFS file. It is similar to our local file, but it is a Hadoop distributed file system. If you would like to know more about this, please watch our video on HDFS file system. To recap, always HDFS stores the file in a divided format. It is a divides the given input file into blocks. So by default, the block size is 128 MB, and this can be configured depends on your requirements. Here, to take an example, the input file is 320 MB, and it is divided into three blocks. That is a 128 MB of two. And one of 64 MB, and these three blocks are stored in the data node. Okay, now let's start the map reduce. As we saw, the map here, it is a map phase which always accepts the input in the key value pair format. Then you may thinking, but our file is stored in some different file format. How mapper will convert that into key value pair format, or who comes and converts our input into key value pair format and gives the as the input to the mapper? Here the record reader comes into a picture. Record reader reads a single record at a time and converts it into a key value pair format and gives as an input to a mapper. Now record reader converts it into key value pair format depends on the input format that you have specified in your job. So let's see different input file formats. The text input format, it is a by default human readable format, and it is stored in the text, and here key is a byte offset. For example, if you have a one text file where you stored in the two lines of data, the first line is hi and second line is TechCore Easy. So first, let's see how it is divided into key value pair format. For the first line, the 0, because the byte offset always start from the 0, so 0 is a key and high will be a value. For the second line, now the offset value will be a 2, because we have a 2 characters in high. So for the next line, the index start from 2. 0 plus 2 is a 2, and 2 is the key, and TechCore Easy will be a value. The second input format is a key value input format. As the name itself indicates, in the from the given line, it divides the file into key into value. So how it divides? All the data before the first tab character is a key, and all the data after the first tab character is a value. This is also a human readable format. The third one is a sequence file input format. As here the data is stored in machine readable format, that is a binary. So if you want to increase the performance, use this kind of file formats. So here the conversion is not required, so the performance will be very faster. And for the key and value, user can define how it needs to find out the key and value. Okay, now to continue our map reduce flow, the mapper get the input from the record reader from the input from the help of input file format which you have specified in the configuration while running the job, it divides the it find out the key and value and gives the pair to the mapper. So you may thinking how many number of mappers, how many number of record readers execute for a given file. It is totally depends on the number of block files stored. In the last example, in the recap, we see that the 320 MB file is stored in three blocks. So here we have a three splits, three different blocks and three recorders. For each block, there is a mapper. So the number of mappers is equal to the number of blocks of a given file, input file. Okay, so now we got the output from the mapper in the key value pair format. The mapper maps the value. Let's take one example, like in the last slides which I had given, you are calculating the age for a given employee. It is depends on the date of birth. So that logic is done in the mapper, and here the key will be age, and you want to find how many number of employees are present whose age is between 20 to 30. So what you do, don't worry, let's see in detail example in the next slide. Just try to understand, mapper is mapping some value to from a given value. Okay, so reducers take the input from the output of the mapper and reduces it. So it aggregates, or the logic what you have written in the reducer, it reduces. So but in Hadoop big data world, reducer always receives all the data belongs to a single key, will go to a single reducer. So who does this? The shuffling comes into the picture. Shuffling shuffles the data from all different nodes wherever the mappers are executing for a given job. It takes the input and it finds out, okay, this is belongs to this key, so it goes to reducer. Then how it find out which belongs to which key? The partitioner comes into the picture. It find out the hashing. It does the hashing of a key, and depends on that hashed value of a key, the shuffling shuffles the data. And before giving the data in as an input to the reducer, the sort just sorts the data, because for the reducer the data is always sorted, and a single reducer have all the data belongs to a single key. So if you look at this reducer, it has only one key and it has all the data belongs to that key. That is simple, right? Yes. And reducers does the reducing part and stores the data in the given dictionary, given directory. And here there are like it stores the data in different part files. If you have a two reducers, then you have a two different part files, and each reducers writes the data in its own part file. And you have a success file which is a 0 byte, and whenever the success file is present in the given directory, you can assume that the map reduce flow job is completed and all the reducers are completed and the data is written into given directory. Okay, let's see one example. So here you have an input and you want to find out how many number of times each word occurred in a given input file. Example, here welcome occurred one time. So in the output you are seeing welcome occurred one time, and two occurred one time. So here you are seeing two occurred one time. Hadoop occurred three times. So here you are seeing three times. So we want to find out how many times each word is occurred in the given input file. So let's assume this is a big file and it is divided into four different blocks of 128 MB. So we have a four input splits and four mappers are executing on each given input, each given block input split. So what mappers mapping map phase is doing here, it is reading data with the help of record reader, and it is dividing the entire line. Depends on the space, it is splitting the line and assigning hard-coded one value to each word. So if you want to find out this how many number of times the words are present, what you do, you take a line, you divide it on the space split the line depends on the space and take the welcome. Okay, it occurred one time, and whenever it occurs second time, you make okay second time. But here for the mapper, it don't know when it next time occurred, so it is just assigning 1 1 1. So each time whenever it see a word, it assigns hard coded value 1 to it, and reducer just take the sum by grouping these words, then it can able to find out how many times it is present. Okay, so mapper output of the mapper will be word, and so here key is a word and value is a hard coded value, that is a 1. And as I told you, all the data belongs to a same key should go to a same reducer. So here we have a three different Hadoop. It is present in three different data nodes, and this should be go to a single reducer. So the data shuffling part is coming into the picture. It is shuffling the data. So if you see those arrows, the Hadoop, one is coming from this node, one is coming from this node, and one is coming from this node. In the same way, shuffle do all the shuffling part and gives the all the data belongs to a same key to a same reducer. Reducer just aggregates, just take the sum and writes the data. Here you may thinking, if we have so many mappers, so many reducers, then our work can run in parallel, then we can have a very good performance, right? But it is not the case. It is not true. Let me give you one real world example. If there is a building construction is happening and you are part of that, your work is, your task is to take the bricks from one place and move it to wherever the construction is happening, provider. Okay, so the rule is you need to take one brick at a time. So what you do, you go to a place where bricks are present, take one, and go to a place where construction is happening, keep there or give to the other colleagues and come back. Take the second one, do this processing. But what if here what happening, you are coming and going, the overhead is increasing. You are capable to take more than one brick at a time, so your movement can be reduced. For example, if you are capable to take two bricks at a time, then you can take two bricks at a time and give it to the your colleague. So if another colleague is capable to hold four bricks at a time, he can take four at a time. So no need to come more three times to take next all those three, one by one, one by one at a time. So in the same way, if you have a more number of mappers or more number of reducers, the performance is not increasing. Example, here you have four mappers, your data nodes or your cluster is capable to execute four mappers at a time, but you compulsory telling I want to execute eight mappers, then what you do, first four will be executed and after that the next four comes into the picture. In the same way the reducer. So if you want to increase the performance, it is totally depends on the data size, and you need to calculate that, and you need to find out how many mappers or how many reducers. It is not true that you set the maximum number of reducers and maximum number of mappers and you will see very good performance, your job will finish very fast. That is not the true. Okay, I hope you liked our video. If you enjoyed watching this video, please like and subscribe our TechCore Easy channel. We make technical core concepts easier for you. Thank you.